Just tell him not to swear though, otherwise right. We'll have to do the link again, won't we?
Right, you're live on air with me and Coey. What do you want?
I'm live with you and Coey.
Yeah, you're live on air now with me and Coey. What do you want?
Is that you, Mark?
Yeah.
How are you, pal?
I'm fine, thank you very much.
Good on.
What time did you finish? Because I've just had light on the phone, but I couldn't answer that one either. Hello? Hello?
Oh dear.
Oh dear. Oh dear, we seem to have lost him. Due to technology, we seem to have lost him. Oh, he's back. What happened then?
I don't know. You must have turned me off. You must have thought I was going to swear or something.
Well, don't swear, because this show's going out live to America on that weekend. You know what I mean?
No.
Right, so...
What time are you available?
About 12 o'clock. Is that all right?
How many?
About 12-ish. Where are you then?
Well, I'm in Morrison's at the minute.
Well, why don't you come back with him and come to mine?
Because he doesn't come back there.
Oh, does he not? Well, why don't you just come back to mine anyway?
Eh?
Why don't you just come to mine anyway?
It's easy for me to go home. I've got all the shopping to take home.
Alright, take your shopping home then.
Is this
the lead singer I am talking to here from Benefit State, the punk rock band? I've got to set me shopping home.
Have you got your pinny on, Mark? Your tabard?
I will.
Right, what I'll do, as soon as we finish this show, I'll give you the bell back, pal. Alright. Alright, I'll speak to you later, mate.
See ya, mate.
Oh, there you go. Now the building works, that's in Studio 2, isn't it?
Oh, my God, we just can't get through this today, can we?
No,
we're having some alterations done in Studio 2. We told them be quiet for the next hour, but obviously they don't understand us.
Obviously they got to earn the pennies.
Well, they have, yeah.
So there they are, drilling away. If you can hear any drilling, it's not done deliberately. It's not us, is it, mate?
No, it's the contractors.
Surely the contractors, that'll be ripping us off later.
Right, so you went to Salford then?
Went to Salford. Absolutely fantastic game, mate.
Good day.
Oh, I was proud of him.
You know, I wish I'd have gone yesterday. I sat in the house listening to...
To the game?
To the show. No, I didn't listen to the game. I watched United.
And you heard a buzz before that?
I heard the...
Language is a big choice, but...
Yeah, and I thought there was too much swearing. But when you get in general public... on the mic and you're in a pub and they're full of beans and stuff like
and
that
and it was all giddy because he was all got at games. It's a bit difficult. I was going to do one on the coach and then I thought I'll do half on the coach and half on the way back, because I was sober,
yeah,
I seen what it was like on the way back. It was all singing songs, it was all swearing,
yeah, well, you know, so you can imagine that, can't you?
But for the team performance, Salford, no, are absolutely fantastic, and you really do have to get behind that team, because they're playing great.
That's a great result yesterday, because not many teams will go there and
put 32 past them
and get a win there.
No,
and we've been unlucky, really. We've only lost in the last two games. We lost by 5 points in both games.
And they played two top teams as well. They played Wigan and they played Warrington.
4 points by Wigan and 1 point by Warrington.
There's no individuals in the team they play as a team. They play as a unit.
You know, if you look at it, there's a bit of a pattern emerging, I think.
Yeah.
And I don't want to go too much into it because obviously Dennis does his show later on. But if you see the Wigan game, there was winning there and they got overcome in the last minute. Try, wasn't it?
Yeah.
In the last minute. Which was a dodgy try.
But we won't go on about that.
Nonetheless. And then, obviously, you've got Warrington from the league.
Yeah.
And they scored a drop goal in the last minute. So, alright. So, and then yesterday they won.
Yeah.
They fought back. So, essentially, Salford seemed to be turning that around. From 4 points to 1 point.
Yeah.
From a winning advantage. And they got a winning advantage yesterday and they capitalised on the winning advantage. And the break by Ben Masilla.
Chicken Tikka Masala.
Murdoch Masilla. Or Masilla Murdoch, whatever.
I mean, they call him Chicken Tikka Masala.
BMM. he killed the game off. Daryl Powell on the...
They all played well, mate.
Yeah.
From 1 to 17 again, they all played well.
Yeah.
And Dobson's a revelation since...
He's turned it round, hasn't he? Yeah. I always thought he was good when he played for Huddersfield, mate.
Yeah, he's got a fantastic kicking game, isn't
he? He has, yeah.
Oh,
has.
Unbelievable.
And it's coming on now, isn't it? So...
Well, because he's got Ben.
Shame about Robert Louis, isn't it?
Yeah, Robert Louis, sorry, I said Ben. Because, it's like a triangle. It's like him. Big Ben.
Mm.
and Robert Louis. They're like a triangle, mate. And then you've got like O'Brien at the fullback, and he's marshalling everything.
Well, he's going to come into standoff next time.
And then he's going to put nine levels at the back.
Players player of the year, even.
Yeah, he'll be, you know, he's a good lad, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. Right, so we'll move away from that now.
We'll talk about that tonight with Dennis.
We're going to go to Islands in the Stream by Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers. And this one goes out to
the lovely Mandy Coleman.
The lovely Mandy Coleman. Yes. And this is for you, sweetheart.
And what a great choice as well.
Baby, when I met you, there was peace I know. Set out to get you with a fine tooth comb. I was soft inside. There was something going on. You do something to me that I can't explain. Hold me closer and I feel no pain. Every beat of my heart, we got something going on.
Kenny Rogers with a country classic going out to the love of your life.
Yes, it was.
Right, well, have you been up to the weekend, Paul?
Right, well, I got myself, Mandy bought me a new bike last week, a road bike. So I've been out on a couple of cycles. The other day I went to Bury and Back.
Yeah.
for the ride. That's about 12 mile, I think.
Oh, I don't think I could. I need to might go and do a bit of that.
16 mile. And then Friday night I did the show, obviously. Yeah, stayed in show. Friday night.
Got a lot of listeners, that. Improved, yes.
Happy days.
I think maybe it was because them Scousers had something to say. I think that pushed it up a bit.
Maybe, yeah.
But
yeah, yeah.
Still, never mind.
Yeah, so...
Our views are our views on the show, and they'll always remain our views.
Well, it's everybody's got an entitled to their opinion, aren't they? Mm. So Saturday morning I got up, and we went for a bike ride into Manchester and back, just for a bit of... exercise.
Yeah.
Saturday afternoon, I went and watched my lad play rugby for Berry Broncos.
I believe he had a good game again.
Yeah, he's a good player, Harry.
Yeah, I know he's a good player. He's always been a good player.
For 16 years of age.
Big lad as well, innit? Big unit.
He's 6 foot four, innit?
6 foot four. Oh, that's some size, that, mate.
So he scored. He took a lot of responsibility on Saturday. He scored 3 goals.
Yeah.
2 drop goals.
Is he a goal kicker now, yeah?
He's always been a goal kicker. Oh,
right.
He's always been a goal kicker.
So, always a good way to get your name in the paper, kick the goals.
Yeah, I suppose it is.
You know what I mean? At least, have a drop early doors and then you're in the paper.
And there's a few clubs interested in him, apparently, so. But he's 16, he's got a long way to go, blah, blah, blah.
He should get down there, then. Salford should be down there, shouldn't he?
Well, I think Salford are going to watch him.
Yeah.
Because his coach, Liam's, something to do with the Salford under 16, so.
Is he?
Yeah.
So, well, they've got to get him down there, haven't they?
I'd have thought so.
He's had the experience of St. Helens.
He's had Australia as well.
He played a game in Australia once when he was a bit younger, didn't he? What I remember.
Yeah, and we went to see Chelsea, my daughter, for the 18th, and because we was away for 7 weeks, I thought I was going to miss too much rugby. And he was 10 year old at the time, so I got in contact with a club called Cranbourne Raiders, I think.
Cranbourne Raiders?
Cranbourne Raiders. It's
right.
A suburb of Melbourne.
Right.
Anyway, I got in touch with the gaffer there, the chairman there. And so I explained it to him. He said, yeah, bring him down.
Cobber,
yeah. Well, he's a South Sea Islander.
Yeah.
So I took him. He's more than welcome. Took him down there. We took him there twice a week while we was down there, trained and whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
And then... The day before we left, it was a season opener, Melbourne versus, I think it was St. George Illawarra.
Yeah.
At Olympic Park, and he played at half-time. And
brilliant, that, isn't it?
Scored 2 tries, and he won 2 tries to 1. So,
brilliant.
Yeah,
brilliant.
In front of a packed house at Olympic Park. So,
brilliant,
yeah,
I bet he was all like, he's had a little pom on the wing.
Yeah. Get the pommy,
I got smashing.
So Saturday I went to see him, and then... After the match, we went into the Orange Tree in Prestwich, had a few beers there.
Socialised
with the rugby crowd, like you do. Yeah, it's great social, isn't
it? Yeah, it's a good drink when you're social mob, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And then I went home, and my niece and a friend came round. We had some tea. We had a bit of a get-together.
Yeah, family get-together. You can't beat them,
can you? Yeah, and yesterday, I listened to your show, got up and did all the washing. Got it all out on the line, proper pinned up, made for tea, and made for heaters for tea.
It's like me, we're going to have to get extra cleaners in here.
Yeah.
With all the building work we've got going on.
Yeah, I didn't sleep last night. I went to bed about 1 o'clock.
Oh, I'd like to say a massive thank you as well to Jade from the Piggy Bank for sending me an email this morning
saying that's
sorted. So thanks very much for that. If you're listening, Jade.
Yeah, that's fantastic. That's
fantastic.
That'll help us on. No end.
Yeah, of course it will, because it'll give up. Like other DJs, the opportunity now to have their own mic and download the songs, won't it?
Yeah, it'll
save us loads of time. So, thanks very much to the Piggy Bank.
Yeah, so, and I was up again this morning at 7:15. Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's like me.
You got to work and you get up at 7:15.
Like me, I was shocked when I seen you online. So, I thought, get in touch, see if I do a show. Bam, get it started.
I've got to go to the other house this afternoon and tidy it up a little bit. We've got the landlady coming around. I think they're starting to show tenants around it.
That's right.
Really, most of it's out. Just wants cleaning up. There's still a few bits to move out, but I've been there for another month. Yeah, just paid the rent for another month.
Have you?
So
you've been right with them then, haven't you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. I want to get out of it early, but the estate agent said no. Just see the contract out. So I've paid my last month.
You're better off doing that, aren't you?
Really?
Although it's like giving a month's rent away, isn't it?
Well, I was signed up to it, so
got you by the short and curlies, haven't you, mate?
Well, to be honest, it's only right, isn't it?
Yeah, it's only right.
Business is business, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, business is business.
It just wasn't for me, that house, really, so I've moved back into my old
house. Right, we've got a couple of special requests. We've got the Carpenters, Top of the World, which is for all the Salford fans. For all the Salford fans that went to Cash's today, and all the Salford fans anyway.
Yeah.
But I was talking to Ray Dix, I said I'd give him a mention, and he said to me, he said, I've never seen this sort of support at Castleford before.
Great, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great. And it's about time that the fans started getting behind.